हेलो एंड वेलकम टू इंटीग्रेटेड मेडिकल बायोकेमिस्ट्री विद डॉक्टर बिजोया। टुडेज टॉपिक इज सिस्टम्स बायोलॉजी। सो दिस इज अ लेक्चर सीरीज इन विच टुडे वी शैल बी डूइंग द ओमिक्स टेक्नोलॉजी। सो लेट अस सी व्हाट इज सिस्टम्स बायोलॉजी एंड व्हाट डज द ओमिक्स। सो सिस्टम्स बायोलॉजी इज एन अप्रोच इन बायोमेडिकल रिसर्च to understand the larger picture at the level of organism, tissue or cell by putting its pieces together. It is in stark contrast to the decades of reductionist biology which involves taking the pieces apart. So systems biology is basically an integrated view of the whole picture rather than isolating different parts and viewing them in isolation. As we all know that nothing is in isolation and we are all interconnected, so systems biology intends to give us a complete picture. Now the suffix omics is used to describe something big and refers to a field of study in life sciences that focuses on large-scale data or information to understand the life summed up in omes and omics. So as I said that today we'll be talking about the omics technology. The word omics is something related to large amount of information. And we are now going to learn about these two terms, omes and omics. So the word om, pronounced as aum, is an ancient Sanskrit intonation made up of three Sanskrit letters A, U and Ma, which when combined together makes the sound Aum or Om, which signifies fullness, as in a divinity that encompasses the entire universe in its unlimitedness. So the word Om gives you a holistic picture where the individual or a part of the body is not into consideration, but the whole body or all the whole picture is important in order to understand the various pathologies or physiologies in a body. So the word omicist means a scientist who studies omiomics, integrating all the omic subfields such as genomics, proteomics, epigenomics and interactomics. So these are specialists, omicists are scientists which study integrated biology. Now systems biology is actually a holistic approach. We cannot say that everything is about chromosomes or everything is about the genes. When we study the genes, we come to know that only a small part of the entire DNA codes for proteins. So all the products of genes, the products of RNA, the proteome, metabolome, phenome and ionome, they all form the complete integrated omics, and this is the systems biology which helps us to relate to different processes going on in a species, in an organism or various organisms. Now the omics revolution began at the end of the this century, which advanced in resulting in the birth of a few technologies or few branches such as high throughput DNA sequencing led to evolution of genomics. High throughput analysis of RNA led to the birth of transcriptomics. Protein classification and its profiling led to the birth of proteomics. Similarly, lipid profiling led to the birth of lipidomics, and the study of various carbohydrates in details in different conditions led to the growth of glycomics and various other metabolites, which led to a complete birth of a new branch known as metabolomics. So all these combination is known as the omics revolution. This is the reference from where I have taken this. Now, the primary aim of omics is to study all the products of the genes, the transcripts, proteins, and metabolites, and it uses certain technology. So, the technology that is used to study the omics is known as omic technology, and it is non-targeted identification of all gene products, whatever the product may be, whether it is a transcript, it is a protein, or a metabolite. Metabolite can be a lipid, or it can be a carbohydrate. So, the study, non-targeted identification of these gene products is the primary aim of the various technologies that is used to study the omics present in a specific biological sample. The omic technologies are basically high throughput technologies, and they increase substantially the number of proteins or genes that can be detected simultaneously to relate to a complex mixture, to complex effects in form of gene or protein expression profiles. Now you can see here that this is the DNA. DNA is transcribed to mRNA. mRNA is translated to protein, and proteins give rise to various metabolites through their enzyme action. Now, the study of all the DNA present in a cell is known as genome, cell of an organism. Study of all the mRNA transcribed is known as the transcriptome. All the proteins present in a cell in a particular condition is known as proteome, and all the metabolites of a cell in a particular condition is known as metabolome. So the genome is related to DNA, so it studies everything such as mutations and epigenetic modifications. Transcriptome is related to mRNA, so here all aspects of RNA metabolism are discussed, such as post-translational modifications and post-transcriptional modifications, And once the proteome, we discuss all the post-translational modifications. And in metabolome, we discuss about sugars, nucleotides, amino acids, lipidome, etc., which form all the metabolites in an individual. And it is these metabolites which influence various functions in a human being and which results in a certain phenotype. So this is the complete omics. So the significance of omic technology has opened new hopes towards biomarker discovery, identification of signaling molecules associated with cell growth, cell death, cell metabolism, early markers of cancer detection for accurately diagnosing and treating life-threatening diseases. So this is the clinical significance of omics technology. So the complete omics science includes genomics. So we can study different conditions like susceptibility, severity, response to treatment via genomics. Then transcriptomics. Here we can find out about diagnosis, activity, severity, damage, and response to treatment. Similarly, we can study the same 5 points in proteomics as well as metabolomics. Now, after having the complete picture of these four basic sciences and a combined picture of it, we get a multidimensional understanding of disease, its pathogenesis, and outcome, and therefore it helps us to identify various markers at different stages of disease, and it helps in personalizing the medicine. So subscribe to my channel, like and share, and don't forget to hit the bell icon. Thank you.